get on this thing? Say hello to my boomstick. Bonus area. Fiend bottle.
The voices have increased in frequency and direction of late. They have begun to stay with me long after conversation has ceased and are serving as quite a distraction. I fear others are beginning to notice my preoccupation at the vampire gatherings. I am thinking again of the particular vampire of whom I spoke previously, who I dare not name for my growing fear. If the voices are to be believed, then my caution is warranted, for they speak of his blackest crimes, both past and future. More than once, I have seen the suspicion in his eyes and heard the distrust in his voice when speaking with me. The fear must register on my face, as it is all I can do in these moments to keep from crying out in chorus with the voices.
Indeed. So what about this maze? Did I bypass something that I shouldn't have? Yeah, I don't want to miss out on something, you know what I'm saying? This is apparently, as he says, a maze, and the labyrinth beyond this door. Typically don't like labyrinths in games, but Vampire the Masquerade continues to delight in the maze, so this could, no pun intended, though this could be good. Just don't want to miss it, you know, miss out on content, as where I was going might ultimately lead right to our friend here. And one boom for you. Three doors. That one's locked. Let's go right. Okay. Let's try left. Same, okay. How do I open it? That's locked. Oh my god. Why did I want to do this again? And now this one's locked. Oh, they're both locked except for this one. What? Awesome. That looks different. Oh, look, he opened that. I wouldn't have known that was there. I'm still... Well, I might be on the ceiling, but this is... Okay, never mind. They're both the ceiling and both the floor, apparently. Okay. These are interesting doors. Oh. What are we saying here? Nights? Nights gone by. Nights here without the taste of the master's blood. Its terrible gaze, the sight of the pale moon in the sky. I am lost, trapped here by the master, once his host, loyal servant, but now the victim of his growing mistrust. Ooh, morphine bottle. The fractured surface of his paranoia, hearing the screams beyond the sewers? Behind these walls, something has happened. Something unnameable. The beginnings of a harrowing madness that I surely will not survive, apparently. Okay, now I hear music. Then we got this door. Some kind of classroom. Famous doctor dies in accident. 28 February 1925. The unrecognizable corpse of renowned shrink Dr. Alistair Grout was found in his burning car as it crashed into the Hollywood Hills today. 3! The sun. It ain't pretty, but it's true. $1.25. That is expensive for a 1925 paper. Holy hell. Alright. Getting insight in the man before the madness. Let's see what's up here. Oh, this exits out. Have I been here?
I am no longer safe. I know it. The voices have proven themselves authentic, and I have withdrawn from the vampire society entirely.
This is new.
My absence will no doubt draw attention, but I could no longer hold my fragile composure around the ravenous eyes of my vampire peers, especially not around him. The voices compelled me to make what I fear is a Faustian bargain, but I had to, for their demands are constant and merciless. I have secluded myself within the mansion. I know he will strike out at me. He will go to any length to achieve his ambitions, and he knows it, I know. I have taken precautions to protect my beloved wife. Her cure will have to wait until our immediate safety is guaranteed. The mansion was constructed with security in mind, but at that time I was not privy to the full range of vampire capabilities. The voices echo in the twisted corridors of my psyche, dark whisperings of a macabre and formless menace, the approach of which portends an end to all of this.
Hmm. Yeah, that's the thing with the Malkavian, is you're not completely sure. Are they just insane, or do they have insight beyond what others do? So this is where I climbed up. Okay. Okay, so I went through the maze. Is there more than just this? If there's something else in the maze to find, even if it's something like a morphine bottle or an interesting scene, I want to see it. So I will mess around in the maze a little bit more. Not forever, mind you, but... Look at that. That looks like a section of the wall that could open. I don't know how to open it. These things don't move. Just came from here, and is it through here? It's through these double doors, yeah. That's still locked. Let's go this way. So twisted, man. Ugh. Locked. I can't even... Can I get to that? I don't see the little icon pop up that I can even open it. Maybe I can't get close enough. I don't know. So here we've got just one door. Ugh. And we've got this door. Yeah, it doesn't look like it can even... open it, no. If this were real, I would be crawling like this. Alright, still locked on this side. Oh god, let me go. That was annoying. Alright, looks like I'm stuck in an endless loop. Let's go back if we can. Maybe we can't. Come on. Ugh. Okay, that's enough already. Ugh. Okay, don't go back through that door. Okay, we're upside down. I can go either way. We're outside. That's locked. That way is bad. We got this and this. Oh, wow. The missing heads. Oh! I'm on fire. Light, of course, duh. The first time I've seen this as a vampire. I got a driver's license? I hope that was worth it. Burning. Hopefully that will help. So I still have to do... hit this. What's it say? Open. Oh, that's on the other side. Get out of the sunlight. Ouch. Well, I can't even open that. It looks so inviting, too. So that opened on the other side, I think. Well, that opened the outside. It opened that. I'm not sure if that's really helping me. Well, these have heads. So there's that. And there's the other heads. This is freaking fascinating, and I have no idea why. Open that. Stairs up, and there's this. I can move these. They are? I'm a little nervous at this point, I guess, eh? So I guess I automatically picked up that morphine bottle. Now I got 5, okay. Oh, and I got a license. Driver's license. A California driver's license. The name on the license is Kent Allen Ryan. Okay. Who is that, and why is Kent Allen Raven important to me? 467 Fair Drive, apartment 202, Costa Mesa, California. He's 5'10", male, hair, unknown, 150 pounds. Oh, expired logo. Alright. I found some neat items here. Very interesting. Okay, the mannequin's having sex or something. I don't know why. Why do I want to be here again? What is this? A clock or something. So we unlocked this for what? Those mannequins there before? They are moving. Yet they have moved. Am I going to be attacked by these things? That's freaky. Oh, I don't know if there's a point to this place. Or it's locked now. It is locked now. Oh, the phone's ringing. Hello? They do? Right, they moved again. So now what? I can't affect them. At least not that way. It looks like there's a... Well, there's a door past it, but those doors aren't actually real, are they? Well, I can't get through here. Or not? Okay. Go back upstairs? Are they eating each other or doing it? Okay, now the mannequins are gone from up here. Now they're down here. Or were they already there? I don't even know anymore. They're facing that way now. Should I try to leave now? Oh, it looks different out here, doesn't it? But I got out. What the hell was the point of all that? Was there a point of all that? I think I have not been this way, maybe? Hello?
Stop doing that. Mother shan't be too pleased.
Who's mother?
Too pleased.
I want to make an outgoing call. I want to tell him I'm looking for father. Okay, so maybe that's it. For the maze of madness. Final night's approaching, that the end of all things is nigh.
I am no longer safe. I know it. The voices have proven themselves authentic, and I have withdrawn from the vampire society entirely. My absence will no doubt draw attention, but I could no longer hold my fragile composure around the ravenous eyes of my vampire peers, especially not around him.
Not the mother?
The voices compelled me
Gold
to
ring.
Make what I fear is a Faustian bargain, but I had to, for their demands are constant and merciless. I have secluded myself within the mansion.
A brain?
I know.
A teddy bear?
Strike out at me. He will go to any length to achieve his ambitions, and he knows it, I know.
Hold on.
I have taken precautions to protect my beloved wife.
I don't want to play both at once.
We will have to wait until our immediate safety is guaranteed. The mansion was constructed with security in
mind. A timepiece?
But at that time, I was not privy to the
teddy
full
bear.
Range of vampire capabilities.
A picture?
The voices
a flower,
echo
rose.
In the twisted corridors of my psyche. Dark
sure
whisperings
is.
Of a macabre and formless menace, the approach of which portends an end to all of this.
Alright. I don't want to play both at once. my gun aimed right at her. So that must be his ailing wife. Is she also a vampire? Oh. Okay. That opened that door. Gonna have to kill her, am I? A teddy bear, a bunny. She might just remain in there. What is that? What is this one? A squished rat or something? Oh, looks like it. Hello, madame. A rose. Oh, two pictures. Is that a picture of the both of them? Oh my. Whoever that is seeing better days. Okay, staked through the heart and then chained to the bed or knit like a crucifix. What happened to his eye? Waiting for that thing to get up. He was torturing that being. That's locked. I guess until we interact with this. I'm gonna remove the stake. Saw the remains of Alistair Grout. Oh, he's dead? You have viewed the charred remains of Alistair Grout. You should probably inform the prince about his demise. Well, that's sad. I don't get to meet the guy.
Hey, Lord, be burned by the flames!
Who's this?